वेलकम। सब्जेक्ट ने मैथमेटिक्स फर्स्ट, सब्जेक्ट कोड MA151, द टॉपिक इज रिव्यू ऑफ मैट्रिक्स। सो दिस इज द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन रिव्यू ऑफ मैट्रिक्स एंड लास्ट लेक्चर आल्सो। सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस सेवरल ऑपरेशन अबाउट ऑन मैट्रिक्स and we studied multiplication of matrices. And to understand multiplication of matrices, we took one example in which A matrix was 1, 5, 2, 7, 3, 4. It was a 3 by 2 matrix. And second matrix B was 8, 4, 3, 1, 2, 5, 8, 6. So it was a 3 by 4 matrix. And we calculated the product, the multiplication of A and B. I explained the idea of multiplication in much detail with each and every calculation. Now you will see we can perform all those steps in a very compact way. You look at this. So to multiply the matrices A and B, we can check the compatibility condition that the number of columns in matrix A is equal to three by two, and it is 2 by 4. So the number of columns in A is 2, number of rows in B is 2. So compatibility condition for matrix multiplication is satisfied. So we start multiplication. To do perform multiplication, we need to multiply first row of A with first column of B. So it will give us 8 plus 10. So I directly write 18 here. Then 4 plus 25, so I write 29 here. So to calculate this entry, I have multiplied first row with second column. Next, I multiply first row with third column, so I get 3 plus 40, that is 43. Next, I multiply this first row with fourth column, so I get 1 plus 30, 31. Next, I multiply second row with first column of B, so I get 2 into 8, 16 plus 14, 30. Then, I multiply second row with second column, so I get 8 plus 35, 43. Next, I multiply second row with third column, 6 plus 56, so I get 62. Next, 2 into 1 plus 7 into 6, so I get 2 plus 42, so 44. Similarly, we calculate the third row of AB matrix. So we multiply first row. So we multiply third row of A with first row of B, with first column of B. So we get 24 plus 8, 32. Then we multiply third row of A with second column. So we get 12 plus 20. Again 32. Next, 9 plus 32. So we get 41. Then 3 plus 24. So we get 27. So we can calculate the multiplication of two matrices. Multiplication of two matrices in this. Now, one more important point which I can explain here is that we can have the valuation of A and B, but if we try to calculate BA, if we try to calculate BA, then BA is not defined. As per the matrix multiplication permittivity condition. Why? Because the number of columns in first matrix B is 4 and the number of rows in the second matrix A is 3, which are not equal. So, BA is not defined. Next, we take one more interesting example on multiplication of matrices. This time A matrix is 1, 2, minus 1 and B matrix is 3, 5, minus 2. And if I want to calculate the multiplication of A and B, then I will check the order. So, what is the order of A? The order of A is 3 by 1 and the order of B is 1 by 3. Now, I check the compatibility condition for the multiplication AB, which is satisfied in this case because number of columns in A is 1, number of rows in B is 1. So, AB will be of order 3 by 3. So, I start calculating entries of the resultant matrix AB. So, to calculate AB matrix for 1-1 position, I will multiply first row of A with first column of B. So, I have only one element here in first row of A, one element in first column of B. So, I multiply 1-3. So, the 1-1 position element will be 3. Similarly, for second position element, I will multiply 1 with 5. For the 1-3 position, I will multiply 1 with minus 2, so minus 2. Similarly, second row of A will multiply the first column of B, so we get 6, then 10, and then minus 4. Next, we get minus 3, minus 5, plus 2. So, this is the multiplication of A and B. Next, if I try to calculate BA, now for BA, we need to check the compatibility condition for multiplication. Number of rows of B is 3. Number of rows in B, the first matrix is 3. And the number of columns in the second matrix is also 3. So, compatibility condition is satisfied in this case. So, we can calculate BA. Now, if I try to calculate BA, so I need to multiply the first row of BA, that is 3 by minus 2, with the first column of A. That will give me the 1-1 position. So, I do this. So, I get 3 into 1, 3, 5 into 2, 10, minus 2 into minus 1, plus 2. So, I get 1-1 position element. Now, after this, no row, no any additional column in B and A. And if you identify the order of BA, so you will observe that the order of BA will be 1 by 1. So, it is a 1 by 1 matrix having only one row and one column. So, BA matrix is a 1 by 1 matrix having only one entry equal to 15. So you can see the difference between AB and BA matrix. And you can also conclude that in general, AB multiplication of A and B is not equal to multiplication of B matrix and A matrix. So we can write this fact in this form that matrix multiplication is not commutative. So we can write that matrix multiplication is not commutative. So if we change the order of multiplication, then the result will change. So this property of matrix multiplication is opposite to the multiplication of ordinary numbers. For ordinary number multiplication is commutative. If you multiply 2 and 3, you will get 6, and if you multiply 3 and 2, you will get 6. But this is not with the matrix multiplication operation or matrix. So you can note down this difference. This is an important property of matrix multiplication which we should keep in mind. Next, to understand other properties of multiplication of matrices, I take one example. So the next property of matrix multiplication says that if I multiply a square matrix with the corresponding identity matrix, then I will get the same matrix A. For example, if I take a square matrix 3, 2, 4, 7, it is a 2 by 2 square matrix, and so I will multiply it with a 2 by 2 identity matrix. This is a 2 by 2 identity matrix. Now if you perform actual multiplication, you will find that your result will be the same K matrix. If this is your A matrix, so here you will also get the same matrix. Similarly, if you calculate IA, if you write identity matrix first and then the given matrix A, so in that case also you will get the same matrix. So this means that the identity matrix is like 1 for matrix multiplication. So the identity matrix behaves like 1 for the matrix multiplication. For ordinary number, if we multiply 1 with any number, we will get the same number. Similarly, if we multiply the identity matrix with the corresponding square matrix, we will get the same matrix. So this is a property. Next, there is another type of multiplication for matrices, which is known as scalar multiplication. So, in this idea of scalar multiplication, we can multiply any scalar K with a given matrix. With all the entries multiplied by k. So all the entries will be k times. If we perform scalar multiplication. So all the elements of the matrix will be multiplied with this constant k, with this scalar k. This property of matrices is different than the corresponding property of the determinants, which we will study next. So, using this scalar multiplication, I may explain that concept which I use in skew symmetric matrices. So, while studying skew symmetric matrices, I gave you this example. And suppose if we denote it by A, then A transpose is equal to 0 to 9 minus 2, 0, 6 and minus 9, minus 6, 0. So, now as per scalar multiplication idea, we can take minus 1 comma from all the entries of the matrix, then the resultant matrix will be 0 to 9 minus 2 0 6 and minus 9 minus 6 0. And now we can observe that it is equal to minus A. So for the square matrix A, A transpose is equal to minus A, therefore A is a skew symmetric matrix. So we can understand this process of taking minus 1 out of all the entries with the in terms of scalar multiplication. Next, there is a property of scalar multiplication and transposition. That is, I multiply A and B and then I calculate the transpose of the resultant matrix, then this result will be equal to the multiplication of the transpose of B and A. So we can verify this result by considering examples. For example, take A equal to 0, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, and the second matrix B as 1, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 2, minus 1. Now, matrices A and B have orders 3 by 3 and 3 by 2. So, these matrices are multiplication compatible. So, I can multiply and the resultant matrix AB will be a matrix of order 3 by 2. Now, using our knowledge of multiplication, we can perform this multiplication. Then we will have 0, minus 1, plus 4, 3, 0, 0, minus 2, then 1, minus 2, minus 1, plus 6, 5, minus 2, 0, minus 3. to verify this result, we need to calculate B transpose and A transpose also. Now, B transpose will be 1 minus 2, minus 1, 0, 2, minus 1. So, as we know, we can obtain transpose of any matrix by either all rows into columns or either or all the columns into rows. So, this B transpose similar, we calculate A transpose. A transpose will be 0, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. And 2, 3, 4. So A transpose is this. Now the order of B transpose is 2 by B, order of A transpose B. So A transpose multiplication and it will be a 2 by 3 matrix. And we can perform multiplication in standard. So we get 0, minus 1, 4, 3, we get 1, plus 2, minus 1, plus 6, 5, 1, into 2, 3, minus 1, plus 8, 7, 0, 0, minus 2, minus 2, 0, minus 3, minus 4, 0, minus 4, so minus 8. This is B transpose. Now you can observe that if I calculate the AB matrix, then I will have 3 minus 2 minus 5 and 7 minus 8. And you will find that AB transpose equal to B transpose A transpose. Take any two compatible matrices A and you verify this property of matrix multiplication. Next, after the distance of measurement, this is the idea of measurement. We can say that determinant is a number associated with square matrices only. Remember, determinant is associated with square matrices. If we have x of order a1, b1, b2, it is a matrix. So matrix has no value, it simply is or arrangement of symbols or an equal value x. Determinant of this square matrix is a determinant of order 3. Now, to find the value of determinants of higher order than 2, for 2 by 2 determinant, the calculation is very straightforward. We have a direct cross multiplication type rule. But for higher order matrices, we need to understand the concept of minus or cofactors of the determinants. So, before explaining the procedure of calculating 3 by 3, 3 order or higher order determinants, we need to know the concept of minus and cofactors of a given determinant. We can also associate the idea of minus and cofactor with the element of matrices also. So, by minor of an element of a determinant, by minor of an element, minor of one element of the determinant, we mean the determinant obtained by deleting the row and column at which the element is intersecting. So, to have minor of A1 element in this 3 by 3 determinant, to have minus this A1 in this 3 by 3 determinant, what we will do is delete A1 and we will also delete the column containing A1. So we will have a 2 by we will have a determinant of order 2. 2 by 2 determinant, B2 C2, B3 C3. And we can calculate the value very easily, B2 C3 minus C2 B3. Similarly, we can calculate minor of all the elements of this 3 by 3 determinant. The minor of B1 will be obtained by deleting the row and column containing B1. So, it will be equal to A2, C2, A3, C3. So, this is the concept of minor of an element of the determinant. Similarly, if we have a 3 by 3 matrix, then for 3 by 3 matrix also we can have a minor. But minor will always be a determinant, will have a numerical value. So, we can write minor of A1 element inside a 3 by 3 square matrix also. Next, the second term, cofactor. Cofactors are similar to minus except this sign. So, suppose in general, if I have a determinant, a very large determinant of order n of corresponding to square matrix of order n by n, then if the minor associated with any element aij, if I write minor of aij, particularly in this type of determinant, so you can understand that this determinant means the first position element is a11, then a12, and so on. Then the second row will have a21, a22, similar elements, then a31, a32, similar elements, and in this column also we will have elements up to an1 and then an2, etc. So it is an n cross n matrix, the determinants. So it is a determinant for n cross n matrix of this. Now, if I want to calculate minor of any element aij, then, and suppose if I denote aij by mij, then to calculate mij, I need to delete the row and column containing aij. In that way, I will have minor. Now, if you want to calculate cofactor of this element, then cofactor will be equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j mij. So it may have one additional sign over minor. So cofactors are minus with alternative plus minus sign. So for 1-1 position, minor and cofactor will be equal, because for 1-1 position, the sum of I will be 1, j will be 1, sum of I and j will be 2. So minus 1 to the power 2 is 1. So you can use this idea that minus 1 to the power even is plus 1 and minus 1 to the power odd is minus 1 to develop the sign of cofactor. For A12 position element, the minor and cofactors will differ by a negative sign, because here I is 1 and j is 2. So you can say, a sign scheme for cofactors. Minor they have no sign. To decide the sign of cofactor, we can follow this sign scheme. So, in this sign scheme, the first position will be positive, then alternative, plus minus sign. So, after plus, you have minus, then again plus, minus. So, this scheme of alternative plus minus sign, first position is line and give the sign to give you the sign of now we will use I have to give you reference. So, I take the ability or higher determinants. So, if I have higher minus minus qualification will be plus. So I write plus 3 here. 14 minus 2. And here I have 0. So whatever will be the value of this determinant, the result will be 0. So we get 4 into minus 17 plus 3 into 12. And it becomes minus 68, and this term becomes 36. So the final result will be minus of 32. So this is a way to calculate 3 by 3 determinant. If you want to calculate 4 by 4 determinant, in that case also you can expand that 4 by 4 determinant from any row, any column, and in that case you will have 3 by 3 type minus. And next you can calculate those 3 by 3 determinants by this side. So that process will be very calculated. However, we have a short trick to calculate the 3 by 3 determinants. Instead of calculating in this way, you can apply a scheme systematically, and you can try to calculate the value of the determinant. Alternatively, so look at the alternative way to calculate this determinant. So to calculate this determinant, 4 minus 3, 0, 2 minus 1, 2, 1, 5, 7. So the scheme which I am explaining is like a short trick to find the value, to find the value of a 3 by 3 determinant. So in this trick, with this determinant of order 3 by 3, repeat the first and second column. So I repeat the first and second column. And now to evaluate, look at the principal diagonal and then the next parallel diagonal having 3 elements and one more diagonal having 3 elements. Similarly, we need to go through the opposite diagonal also. So for this I write this scheme again, but if you will practice, then you will be able to perform this calculation in mind also. So there will not be any need to write everything explicitly. This scheme will run in our mind. So considering these three diagonals containing principal diagonal and two other diagonals parallel to the principal diagonal, next we will consider the opposite diagonal having three elements and the two parallel diagonals. And multiply all the elements of a diagonal. So if we multiply 4 minus 1, 7, then we get 28. If we multiply all the elements of this diagonal, so we will have minus 6. If we multiply all these three elements, we will have 0. Similarly, multiply all the elements of this diagonal, this will give us minus 1, and this will give us 40, and this will give us 11. Correct? Okay. This there is 0, so the result will be 0. Now we have calculated these three products. Now we need to sum all the three results. So the sum of these results is 22, and the sum of so here we will have negative 28, and here we will have minus 6, here 0, 0 and 40, and here we will have 14 minus 40. We will multiply these three elements. So 14, 3 is 42. And the sign will be minus because we are multiplying three numbers. So now our calculation is correct. So we sum the resulting numbers. Now here we will have minus 34, and here we will have minus 2, 4, minus 3, 0, 2, minus 1, 2, 1, 5, 7. So we are getting correct. So minus 2. So minus 34 and so we can apply this scheme to find the value of the decimal, minus 34, and then we will have it is 0, it is 5 to 10, 40, it is 14, minus 42, so it is minus 2. Okay. Let me explain this idea using lines. Here 28 minus 28 is correct, minus 3 into 2, minus 6 is correct, here 0 is correct, and here in this scheme I have 0, alright, 10, 40, minus 40, so I get minus 2 and minus 34. So the value is, value of the determinant will be the sum of these three elements minus 36. I explained this procedure with the help of another example, the short trick to find the value of the determinant. So this time consider this 3 by 3 determinant, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 2, 4, 8. So first we calculate this 3 by 3 determinant with the help of our Laplacian scheme of calculating P by G determinant. So we expand it from first row, and our minor is 5748 minus here 3, then 4728, okay, and then plus 2, and minor is 4524. And now we calculate. So you can check first whether we have written our minus correctly or not. For 1, 5748, for 3, negative sign, and 4728, and for 2, 4524. Now we calculate the values of these 2 by 2 determinants. So we get 40 minus 28 minus 3, 32 minus 14 plus 2, 16 minus 10. So here we get 40 minus 28, 12, and 32 minus 14, 18, into 3, 54, and then 16 minus 10, 6, into 2, 12. So you can verify this calculation. 14 minus 28, 12, alright. 32 minus 14, 14, 18. So 18 into 3, 54. And here we have 6 into 2, 12. So we will have 24 minus 54, that is minus 30. So the value of this determinant is minus 30 using this scheme. Now if we follow that scheme, so in that scheme we will use the principal diagram 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 2, 4, 8. And I write the first column and second column again. 1, 4, 2, 3, 5, 4. Now, as I explained earlier, we consider this principal diagonal and the two parallel diagonals and multiply all the elements of these diagonals. So we will have 40 and 42 and 32. We check the sign. Alright. So we have 40, 42, 32. Now next, add all these three numbers. So we find that the result is 4, 11. So we have 114, the result. Next, we repeat this procedure with this opposite diagonal. So this is, these are the three diagonals containing opposite diagonals and the remaining two parallel diagonals. And we calculate the product of all the three elements in these diagonals. So we get 20, and here we get 28. Here we get 4 into 3, 12, 8 into 4, 32 into 3, 64 plus 32, 96. So this is the product of 843. So we have these terms. We add all the these terms. So we will have 4 and 4 and 9, 13. So we will have 134. Now 14, so we will have 144 here. Now subtract the principal diagonal from the opposite diagonal and you will have the result. So it is minus 30. So using this scheme we are getting minus 30, using this scheme we are getting minus 30. So if you will understand this scheme, then you can calculate the value of 3 by 3 determinant, particularly in drain nodes. For higher determinants, 4 by 4 order, the usual expansion technique may be applied. Or if you are compatible with this expansion technique, then you can follow this Laplacian expansion technique also. And the calculation of determinant is very necessary. We will use this idea frequently during the course on matrices. Now, after having observed that the calculation of determinant involves a lot of calculation, it is cumbersome and tedious. So, to calculate higher order determinants, some properties of the determinants have been developed. So these properties of the determinant will help us. Properties of the determinants will help us in properties of the determinants will help us in calculating higher order determinants more easily without applying these Laplacian type complicated calculation steps. So look at those properties. Properties of determinants involve first property as the value of the determinant, value of a determinant remains unchanged, while interchanging rows and columns of the determinant. For example, if I take a 2 by 2 determinant, if I have a 2 by 2 determinant, then the value of this determinant will not change if I convert rows into all the rows into columns or all the columns into rows. So the value of this determinant after converting rows into columns or columns into rows will not change. So you can see it is a 2 by 2 determinant and I have converted rows into columns, like the calculation of transpose in the matrices. So the value remains unchanged. Second point is that if in a determinant two rows or two columns are identical, then the value of the determinant will be 0. So if I have this type of determinant, then you can surely say, because two columns are identical or two rows are identical, so the value of this determinant will be 0. The third property of determinant is that if you interchange any one row with another row, for example, if I have original matrix A1, B1, A2, B2, and if I change to first row with second row, so you can see I have interchanged, then the value of the resultant matrix will be the negative of the original matrix. Again, if after this I interchange any column, any two columns, then one more minus one will come here, so I will have minus one square, so it will be equal to class 1. So then again the value of these two determinants will be equal. So whenever we interchange two rows or two columns in a determinant, we need to give a negative, we need to keep a negative sign outside. So this is a third property. The fourth and the important, most important property of the determinant is that if we consider a row or any column, ith row and multiply this ith row with a constant multiple of the another row. If we replace the ith row with the sum of the ith row and kth multiple of another row, then the value of the determinant will not change. Similarly, for column also. For column also we can say that if we change ith column with ith column plus k some constant multiple of other column, then the value of the determinant will not change. So you can see, you will find this property surprising, but it is true. For example, I extend this idea again with the help of 2 by 2 determinant. So the value of this determinant will be equal to another determinant in which if I replace first row by the constant multiple of second row. So I keep second row as such, but I have changed first row by this property. What I have done is that I have multiplied k multiple of second row with the first row, and I have replaced first row with this first row plus k multiple of second row. We can use these properties to calculate the value of the determinants which involve large number, which involve large calculation. For example, 427, 429, 3937. More than this determinant with 3936. If we are proper, so if apply this property, the two column by C2 minus C1 by my K minus 1, so can replace C2 by my and then, so if you will apply this column, then here also 2, so we can simplify it by applying 1 minus R2 operation. So you will get 1 minus 369, so you get 58, 369, 0, 369, 2. The second row is first row, and we can calculate 2 by 2 determinant VG equal to 58 into 2 minus 0 into 369. 0, the second term will go, and here we 116. So the value of determinant is 116. So you can observe that can display the use of higher determinants for determinants involving large number with the help of operation. By trying to create as many zeros, so how so many zeros we create, make our calculation much easier. Now after any determinants, I will discuss the concept of surface. In a matrix A, the diagnosis of matrix that is coming here is then